I'm in my 30s. It feels different than a few years ago. I started getting those pains. Pains I had heard of, but wasn't sure why they were such a big deal, like back pain after sleeping in an awkward position. And then recently my fingers started going numb. I learned it was nothing serious and it was caused by working from the couch, putting my hands in the wrong position. I was recommended a set of exercises and to use a desk. Now, I've been working in healthcare for more than 10 years. Of course, I was going to take it seriously. I was very diligent. But somehow, after the first week, I was back working from the couch. My physiotherapist was not impressed, but also not surprised. We are not good making changes in our behaviors. How many people in India do you think change their unhealthy habits after heart bypass surgery? Just 1 out of 10. And if we look across geographies and health issues, we're going to find somewhat similar numbers. Medicine needs a new ally to help us make changes for better health. What if I told you that we already have half the solution and that it's in your pockets? It's the mobile devices and digital technology that we can turn to. The idea is not new, but it was only in 2020 that the first digital intervention for patients received FDA clearance and entered the world of certified medicine. Let me tell you about digital therapeutics, also called DTX, what it is, how it works, and why most likely you have not heard of it. It can be an app that coaches us what to do when we have back pain and helps us understand what triggers it so it can be resolved long-term beyond taking painkillers. It can be an app that guides us how to turn negative habits into a positive one and helps chronic disease patients enjoy life. DTX can take many forms as apps, platforms, and software. They can be provided on their own or together with drugs and devices. They also aim to tackle a broad range of health issues. Some DTX offer treatment for conditions that don't have drugs available for them. How can this be? We know that when we swallow a drug, it releases biochemicals, and that is what affects the biology of our bodies. But an app? We're not swallowing anything, we're not touching anything. The thing is, our bodies can have a physical response to non-physical inputs too, such as messages, visuals, and sounds. It happens through our nervous system, and that is what many DTX tap on to encode change in behavior. They can also directly lead to nervous rewiring. One example is software that employs music to improve walking ability of a patient after a stroke. You might be also wondering, how are those tools different from the so many wellness apps available in an app store? If DTX are analogical to drugs, wellness apps can be considered supplements. They may be less effective and are often backed by less stringent or no proof that they work in tackling medical issues. In contrast, DTX are certified medical tools. They go through clinical testing and are backed by similar evidence as traditional drugs. Some DTX are only available on prescription. Meet Lakshmi and Dhruv, her 10-year-old son, very active, recently diagnosed with ADHD. Dhruv was prescribed a daily dose of DTX. He steers a virtual character in a game on his tablet. It's fun. The tasks and challenges are designed to improve his ability to focus, which transforms his skills outside of the game too. within 2 months, Dhruv became a better student. Lakshmi also noticed that the game gave them a new language to communicate about Dhruv's attention struggles. DTX brought them closer. Meet Ravi, 57-year-old father of two who was recently diagnosed with diabetes. He was prescribed a glucose monitor and a DTX app. He was relieved to find out that his favorite snack, Pani Puri, did not contribute to the glucose spikes the app advised him to avoid. He also received prompts for short physical activities and tips for better sleep, as well as encouragement and breathing exercises to cope with anxiety. Ravi is in control of his health. More importantly, he enjoys gardening and playing with his grandkids. His definition of a successful treatment. And all of this provided by software. The physician who oversees Ravi's condition can now work with more patients than before. She also sees less patients with advanced diabetes that require more care and resources. Empowering change early and doing it at scale is what really excites me about this technology. It has all the potential to help us tackle the issue of limited resources, one of the greatest challenges of the healthcare system around the globe in India and Singapore alike. With so much promise, why don't we see more of it? In our research for a book at the National University of Singapore titled Medicine Without Meds, my colleagues and I did nearly 100 interviews and confirmed. Technology alone cannot reinvent healthcare. It requires the spheres of technology, medicine, and business to work together. The developers ought to provide evidence beyond technical performance. Physicians and patients should embrace technology when backed by evidence. And the payers should provide commercial mechanisms that support DTX. When the stakeholders of the ecosystem work together, we can trust DTX to activate medical devices in our pockets and pave the way for better health and brighter future for millions of people. People such as Lakshmi, Dhruv, and Ravi. People such as you and me. Thank you.